Namaste. Today in this podcast of Get Right to Education, we will listen about the Sojourner Truth. Let's start. Sojourner Truth, 1797 to 1883, was a black American freedom fighter and orator. She was born Isabella Womfrey in Ulster County, New York, the daughter of an African named Womfrey after his Dutch owner and a woman called Elizabeth. About the age of 9, she was auctioned off to an Englishman named John Neely. The Neelys understood very little of her Dutch jargon, and as a result, she was often brutally punished for no real reason. Eventually, Neely sold her to a fisherman who owned a tavern in Kingston, New York. Here, she acquired the idiomatic expressions which came to mark her speech. John J. Dumont, a nearby plantation owner, purchased her next. During her tenure with his family, she married and had 5 children. In 1827, after New York had passed an Emancipation Act freeing its slaves, she prepared to take her family away. But Dumont began to show reluctance to this, so she ran away with only her youngest child. She finally wound up in New York City. She worked at menial job and through some friends came under the sway of a religious fanatic named Matthias. During the Civil War, Truth bought gifts for the soldiers with money raised from her lectures and helped fugitive slaves and work and housing. After the war, she continued her tirade for the Lord and against racial injustice, even when old age and ill health restricted her activities to the confines of a Battle Creek Mick Sanatorium. She died there on 26 November 1883. She was the first black woman to sue and win against the white. Here is one of her famous speeches entitled as "Aren't I a Woman?" which she delivered in the Women's Convention in Akron, Ohio in December 1851. "Well, children, where is so much racket? There must be something out of order. I think that 'twixt the Negroes of the South and women at the North, all talking about rights, the white men will be in a fix pretty soon. But what's all this here talking about? That man over there says that women need to be helped into carriages and lifted over ditches and to have the best places everywhere. Nobody ever helped me into carriages or over mud puddles or gives me any best place. And aren't I a woman? Look at my arm. I have plowed and planted and gathered into barns and no man could head me. Aren't I a woman? I could work as much and eat as much as a man when I could get it and bear the less as well. And aren't I a woman? I have borne 13 children and seen most all sold off to slavery, and when I cried out with my mother's grief, none just but Jesus heard me. And aren't I a woman? Then they talk about this thing in the head. What's this they call it? Member of audience whispers an intellect. That's it, honey. What's that got to do with women's rights or Negro's rights? If my cup won't hold but a pint and yours holds a quart, wouldn't you be mean not to let me have my little half measure full? Then that little man in black there, he says women can't have as much right as men. 'Cause Christ wasn't a woman. Where did your Christ come from? Where did your Christ come from? From God and woman. Man had nothing to do with him. If the first woman God ever made was strong enough to turn the world upside down all alone, this woman together ought to be able to turn it back and get it right side up again. And now they're asking to do the men better let them. Obliged to you for hearing me. And now old Sojourner ain't got nothing more to say."